Hey everybody, it's 40War. Welcome back to The Legend of Dragoon. Last time we took on a secret boss, the Polter Armor, and saw a little bit of the liberation, the formal announcing from Emperor Diaz, the start of the revolution. But with that distraction out of the way, and some good items in tow, we have to go to the capital city of Vellweb, because that's where Emperor Diaz is telling us to meet. And you'll see more ruins. And kind of fittingly, the Black Castle music comes back. The seven towers represent the seven dragoons. As Lloyd just mentioned, the throne of the Holy Emperor is underneath there. So, we're standing at the place where humans began their liberation. So, much like in Cadessa, where we were at the ruins of the formerly proud Wingly nation, we're now standing at the place where the revolution all began. But because it's a historic ruin, monsters have settled in here as well. So, we're going to be fighting some more, which is fine. I mean, there's nothing here of particular note as far as I remember. I do know of one enemy that's fairly dangerous, but other than that, there isn't anything here to really worry about too much. So, I brought Rose out, but I'm leaving Maru in. And we're going to lead off with probably the most dangerous of the enemies here, the Maximum Volt. They hit hard, and they can also do Thunderbolt. So they also have the most HP of anybody here, I think around 600. Just further exacerbated the fact that these guys mean business. Cool Boogie upgraded to 90 points now. That's a good thing. So I guess for me, the good news of fighting these guys is I can't fight anybody worse. So, that's a good thing. But I mean, doing 300 damage to Dart, that's no small feat.
Die. Heartblade.
If you have that smoke ball, you could probably use it here, and it wouldn't be a bad idea, because these guys are pretty dangerous. Of course, if you want to fight, plug away, you can. Because I found that if you run, you could be potentially underleveled. The smoke ball never enters my mind as a viable option, because I already feel I'm going to be underleveled to some degree as it is, but I can compensate. But the minute you start throwing smoke balls into the mix, you get lazy, and if you get lazy, that's when the problems could start for you. I mean, you don't want to get to a point where maybe in the fourth disc, you're fighting enemies, and you're going, hey, what the hell, I'm struggling with the basic enemy. That has happened to me before. Also, stun did not work on those guys, and I did learn an important detail off-screen. I had the panic bell I got from the Polter Armor fight, won the chess. I burned it. And then, but I used it after stunning an enemy with Maru's hammer. When I used the bell, it became unstunned, but it became confused, so there's no stacking. Once you get a status ailment, it can only be replaced or dispelled. And Maru was about to stun him again and probably fail, because he's probably invulnerable to it. So that wasn't really a pretty fight, but the good news is they're not the most common enemy. So, simply continue onward. It's kind of interesting to actually see this music again, because we haven't seen the Cosmos music in two discs now. And it's kind of appropriate, too, because the music is playing with the Emperor when we're meeting an Emperor. First was Emperor Dol and Sergio, and now it's going to be Emperor Diaz here. These are more common enemies, the Witch and the Terminator. Which goes without saying, knows magic attacks. The Terminator, I think, knows an all-out attack. It looks cool as heck, though. And you see the, what is that, chakra and a claw or something? I mean, I kind of like the look. And Maru, for the third straight time, failed to stun something after it said you stunned something. Go figure. Also in this part, I hope to get Rose's last edition. Oh boy, he's going to the auto-attack already. God damn you. God damn you. So, Terminators are less dangerous, really, than the Maximum Bolt counterparts. Although, that was not in the plans. Which obviously is not as physically imposing, as you can see from 152 damage already. But I don't remember them actually being particularly threatening. Oh geez, Charging Spirit's coming. You know what that means? That means... Well actually what that means is I'm throwing a Signet on his ass. First. That should do it actually. Once this battle is done, we should actually see Rose with the new edition. And I can actually show off what one of those special editions looks like. So that's going to be kind of exciting. If you like playing with Rose as much as I do, that sounds wrong, but forget the dirty connotation. If you enjoy using Rose as much as I do, typically, you can get this in Disc 2. And then be on the fast track to maxing that edition out. And those editions, those final editions, I probably mentioned before very early, are ridiculously good. They're difficult as heck to master, but the damage outputs and the SP outputs are ridiculously high. Demon's Dance for Rose. And, oh boy, when you get one of these for the first time, it's a doozy. Incredibly, Dart's Master Edition, which I probably will not be shown in this LP, isn't countered, which is odd to think about, but as you see, 7 hits. They all will have 7 hits, but look at the SP, look at the damage to start. That is not something to laugh at, and we're talking about some of these editions, the SP can get as high as 200 and the damage can get as high as 600. I think Rose's might be the most damaging of the bunch. It might be Dart's, but I'm not sure. Either way, you're going to see pretty difficult addition being pulled out here. One that could be countered anywhere from hits 3 to 6. And they're not always the easiest ones to catch, mind you. But if you can master those additions, you can master anything. So, also, two more Peddler Brothers. The other two. I think they would be what? Segundo and Cuarto? I think? No, Tercero and Primero. Yeah, there's no customers here because there's none but monsters here. You can't sell anything to the witches or the Maximum Volts. These Peddler Brothers are... I don't know where to say they have a great enthusiasm or optimism, but they're Bacchus. But anyway, here's customers. So, just like a Segundo and Cuarto, we can buy stuff from them. And let's see what they have to sell for us. Well, a partisan is a weapon for Albert. The heavy mace, so Maru has that. Hashel can get a girdle. Okay. And you get a Gigantic Ring, which just basically ups your physical prowess. But why would you ever want to become anything like Kongol? Let's be honest. I know that sounds horribly wrong to say, but let's be real here. You wouldn't. Thank you. And as far as our friend here, Tercero, well, nothing unusual. I mean, if you're getting sick of battle, you can buy a couple charm potions. But once again, the reason I don't do it is because I can get kind of underleveled if I keep running all over the place. I'll keep burning wave. I could use that somewhere in disc 4, kind of shortly. But, oh, that's a little bit of ways away. We're actually very close to the end of disc 3. Vellweb is the last place we need to visit. And Vellweb is important because when you meet Diaz, you're going to get the big plot dump. And I get to show off Rose's skill here. But before I do that, let's just put the Wicked Witch in a bind. You know, impromptu healing and the whole nine. Plus, Muru can't harm nothing. I mean, Muru doesn't hit very hard, so I don't mind doing it with her, and she can't move and she's stunned. Which one would you like to suffer with first? A true case of pick your poison, if you ask me. Anyway, I'll skip to when I actually use Rose for the butt kicking. Alright, let's roll. So, this is gonna be interesting. I got away without one, which is nice. But some of Rose's counters are easily catchable, like the fourth and the sixth one. The third one's tricky, and the fifth one I've caught before. So, it's a mixed bag, for all intents and purposes, and a lot of them are mixed bags. I've used all of them before, but I can't remember anything outside of Dart's edition, which is really an easy edition, believe it or not, and Rose's Demon's Dance, because I've used that most recently. So, if you... I could spoil Dart's, because I'm not going to see it, but I really don't know it. I really don't remember any of the others. I'd probably have to upload them on find them on YouTube or something. And maybe, I don't know. Or maybe edit something in, I don't know. But Darts is one of the easiest because it really is a hit and then 1, 2, 3 with then a pause and then 1, 2, 3, like very, very simple cadence. I talked over the fact that Rose was showing us a little bit of history. Another relic. But as you go further, we will be greeted by Shirley. Kind of interesting that Shirley is here because one of the former Dragoons from the Dragon campaign is sitting here. And this is actually another side quest you can do. Shirley talks about the trapped souls alone in this world. And the trapped souls are 4 of the Dragoons who lost their lives during the campaign. Which then... And these are the other 4, okay? I mean, we knew about Zeke, who became Dart's father, allegedly. And somehow... Or was petrified or something. I'm not sure which. I don't even know anymore. I don't even know what's what anymore. It's all a cluster muck. And then you have Rose, who's right there. And you have Shirley, who's right there. So, the other 4. Mayfield is just a more talk you'll learn about later. But, the point being, there are 4 Dragoons who need to be sent to rest. But, it's recommended you only do this after the fact. They can range from moderately difficult to atrocious. One in particular is a pain in the neck. The others aren't too bad. But the good news is, you get a free heal point here. And a free save point too, which is also very important. Incredibly, Vellweb also has a Stardust. I know, it doesn't make much sense to have Stardust stashed in a dungeon, but that actually is the case. Go figure. So, it's actually kind of crazy. Now, if you want the Stardust, just simply go to the tower above you. Of the other ones, of the other six, four of them will be boss fights. And if you enter them, you have to fight. There is no enter, go a couple spaces, and then fight. You have to fight right then and there. Anyway, time to take out some trash. I actually got a flash hole from those guys, and I was mistaken. The maximum volt used spark net during the battle. And somehow I actually caught the third counter on Rose. That I didn't expect, because that's the toughest one for me to get. But it caught my first try, so more power to me. Anyway, that's the only Stardust remaining here. That leaves four to go. And I believe there are four in Disc 4, so with that, we'll actually have all 50. We're actually on our way. And as you leave here, you get into another fight. Yawn. Hey, new enemies! So you've seen the Terminator before, but the spark hitters can actually steal stuff from you. They're also not particularly threatening. So, I mean, I don't consider them that big a deal. I mean, they could hurt you a little bit, I guess, but the thing that makes them unique is their ability to jack stuff. Just once, I wish you would miss that attack, because it'd be funny. You little bitch. You little snot. This does not please me. This makes me very angry. Now I'm going to have to defend. And what better way to heal than to do a speed up and a speed heal, a speed guard. Operation Speed Guard, commence. So anyway, I really don't remember much about the Spring Hairs other than being relatively weak, kind of like the witches. Although they seem to be kind of quick. A little too quick. But we'll get rid of one. That should be all for that guy, yep. So, what, about 500 HP or something? 600 maybe? Not much. As for you, you can F right off. Demons dance. Huh, he ran away. Okay, I didn't really see that coming, but yep, that's fine. So at any rate, you go a little further, you should be able to get an auto heal from Shirley. See? So anyway, with that in mind, this is the way down to Diaz. There's a couple items and stuff you can get here. But ultimately, I'm going to definitely put the entire story in the next part, because it's important, there's a lot of it, and I think it just flows better that way than to just stick it at the end of a part, because there is a lot of critical information there. It is a plot dump, for all intents and purposes. Also, cool boogie upgraded again to 120.
Die. Demons dance.
A little nicely. There also are a couple good items here for him. I remember there's one armor. I just need to remember which way is the right way to go. Because I totally forget. One of these splits leads to something, and one of these splits leads to nothing. I think the fact that I see items down there means I probably should head down that way first. Maybe that way was a dead end. What about over here? I don't want to trigger the, what I want to avoid is actually trigger the, story. I want to wait. We got Rose's hairband here, which basically just avoids instant death. So, not bad. I mean, compared to the Phoenix Plume, not bad. It's kind of a wash, really. So, if you have the Phoenix Plume, it almost just seems like maybe a little bit pointless. But hey, the ability to avoid instant death is not something that's easily dismissed, so, you know, there is definitely something to it. Okay, I think the succubus is here, and that would be the last enemy. I don't remember much of anything about it, but I'm going to take a wild guess from everything I know about succubi and say a witch is in the cards. That's just a guess. Because how many games have you played that have featured succubi doing seductive things? Probably a lot. And well, I'm not gonna fall for it. Other than that, I don't think the succubus really has much of anything. Maybe an HP drain? I don't know. I think I'll fall for that shit. Okay, it looks like you're gonna get nothing off because Maru just stunned your ass. Oh, jeez. Ugh! You had to pull it on the sixth attack. I don't yet ever catch that one because I never expect that one. Because when you take it, when you have the counter appear so late, you're almost, you just get that sense of security like, okay, it didn't happen at 3, 4, or 5. What are the chances of it happening on 6? Relatively low, really. Because it only happens once. That's the whole point. So to see it happen there just kind of throws me out of sorts. Whatever the case, I believe this is the proper way to go. So with that in mind, I think this is a great place to end the part. So we'll see the end of the disc next time. See you guys then, 40 Warriors signing off.